Hello, everyone, and welcome to the Level Up Small Business Training Program. This is cohort number 5. We are so excited to be here with this amazing group of entrepreneurs. I get really excited on this particular night of the program because this gives us the opportunity to hear all of the amazing things that they have learned and gleaned from being a participant in this program. So we are really, really excited to have this set of entrepreneurs and, of course, to partner with Center for Transforming Lives on this initiative to bring entrepreneur education to individuals to meet them where they are in their process. So my name is Darlisa Diltz. I'm the Managing Director of the North Texas Entrepreneur Education and Training Center, where we work to provide entrepreneurship to everyone if they are willing to put in the work. And these individuals have done just that. So I would like to introduce our partners, Center for Transforming Lives. Ms. Ocilia, would you like to start us out?
Yes. Good evening, everyone. Again, welcome to the Level Up Business Program, our enterprise program presentation night. Tonight, we have a group. We have a smaller group than usual. We have 3 entrepreneurs who have successfully completed our program and will be presenting their businesses, whom we are very, very proud of. The Center for Transforming Lives, our Economic Mobility Services Department, and our agency as a whole, we have a mission of specifically helping women to disrupt the cycle of poverty. And one of the ways that you'll see that we do this, and we help some men too. We have one male entrepreneur with us tonight. I don't want him to feel left out. but one of the ways you'll see that we disrupt the cycle of poverty is through our micro enterprise, better known as our small business, our Level Up Small Business Program. Take the time to listen to our entrepreneurs tonight, and you will see just why we do the work that we do. And I have our Economic Mobility Services Director on. I don't know if she wants to say a few words. I'll pass it to Charlotte really quick, and then back to you, Darlisa.
Hello, everyone. Thank you, Darlisa, for your partnership. Thank you so much, Ocilia, for sharing about our mission, because you're exactly right. Our goal is really to look at how can we help Tarrant County families be able to use entrepreneurship as a way to achieve financial prosperity. So we're really excited about the way we're able to provide foundational resources to these entrepreneurs, and looking forward to not only continuing to work through the financial coaching that we offer and other wraparound services, but also creating a pipeline where we can be able to connect them all to other business resource providers, such as Darlisa's organization and other entities throughout the Metroplex. So thank you again.
Thank you all. I remember the very first time, Center for Transforming Lives reached out about the program, and I was like, oh, who, us? You want us to do it? And I have loved it ever since then. I absolutely love the opportunity to connect with entrepreneurs and get them to this point. So you mentioned, you know, that they provide resources mainly, you know, for women. However, we have had some amazing gentlemen to come through the program as well. And so I want to kind of put out there, maybe this is on the spot-ish, but would you guys like to talk about how people can access the program if, you know, they're interested in getting some additional resources for their business?
Absolutely. Absolutely. If anyone that is watching is interested in business development, getting assistance and mentoring as they start or grow their business, as well as access to business grants, part of the program is successful completion of this program gives our participants access to business grants, to micro grants. So if you're interested in that, just log on to leveluptarrantcounty.eventbrite.com. That is how you can register for our info sessions, where we share more information and you can get an application. And I'll say that one more time, levelup.tarrantcounty.eventbrite.com for the Level Up program. Thank you. Somebody put it in the chat box. Thank you. So that's how you can register for one of our upcoming info sessions, learn all about the program and how you can get involved in our next cohort.
Thank you so much, Charlotte. So I'm trying to multitask because I have someone on social world, like, what's the link again? So I'll, sorry if I'm looking off here and there. Okay. So thank you guys for introducing yourselves. So we have some other amazing guests and visitors with us online tonight. So I'd like to take a moment to allow our guests to introduce themselves. So not our presenters yet, but this is still for our guests. If you want to take a couple minutes to introduce yourselves, and we will start with Tyler.
Hi, everybody. I'm Tyler Grant. I am the Donor Relations Manager at Center for Transforming Lives. And I am here because a big part of my role is to capture the amazing work that we're doing as it's happening and share about our successes. So all of you who are here this evening are a part of that story. So if it seems to fit our theme for our upcoming fundraiser or outreach to donors, I will be following up with you about your particular story. So excited to be here with all of you and to celebrate your success and getting an opportunity to practice your pitches. So thanks, everyone.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Tyler. Miss Katrina, would you like to introduce yourself?
Hi, everyone. I'm Katrina McKee, and I am the Economic Mobility Program Assistant. I am a teammate of Ocelia's. I work alongside TEVA with financial assistance in our department to help aid those who may need rental assistance or mortgage assistance within Fort Worth who've been impacted by COVID-19 at this time. I'm excited and congratulations to all of you for completing this cohort. And I can't wait to hear about your presentations.
Thank you so much, Katrina. Miss Marcel, want to introduce yourself?
Marcel McLaurin. I'm a financial coach at the Center for Transforming Lives. I see some familiar faces here. So for those of you that we haven't connected yet, I look forward to working with you. But I'm glad to see all of you here, and I cannot wait to hear your presentations.
Thank you, Marcel. All right. Last but certainly not least, Miss Charlotte.
Good evening. My name is Charlotte Navarro, and I am the Economic Mobility Services Manager with Center for Transforming Lives. So I oversee the financial literacy, career coaching, and micro enterprise. And Ocelia has talked a lot about the progress you all have been making. So we're really excited to hear these presentations. And congratulations for completing this Level Up program.
Thank you so much, Charlotte. And thank you guys again for being on the call. Okay, so for those that are watching, these individuals have undergone development and training over the last 6 weeks to help them craft their business vision from where they were to where they currently are in their operations. So the objective for them as they enter into the Level Up program, they go through a couple of different phases. So we have the pre-venture, which that program is for entrepreneurs that are, they have the idea and they want to get started, but they don't really know just what to do first. So they go through a series of sessions with Ocelia, who helps to get them up to the enterprise level, which once they do the enterprise level, then they have to do a presentation, which is where they are now. The goal is to, one, provide them with a network of individuals that can help them to grow their business from where they are to where they want to be. Two, provide them with some tools and resources that they may not have known about. And three, to help them think outside of the traditional trajectory of starting a business and being a business owner. If you are a business owner, you know entrepreneurship is lonely. So grateful to Center for Transforming Lives and their vision on helping to get individuals a part of the program and through the program. So without further ado, I would like to call on our very first presenter, Mr. Randolph Holly, whose business is Mom Collect Atelier. And he is going to showcase to you guys his business. Randolph, the floor is yours.
Gotcha. Good evening, everybody. Thank y'all for being here. Could have been anywhere else in the world today, but you decided to be here with us. So we appreciate y'all. So I'm going to just jump right in.
Just having to make the decision of either spending for a hotel or spending for food, but not spending for the hotel, knowing that you're going to have to sleep somewhere.
Yeah.
So the challenge of, I would say, sleeping in your car, waking up the next morning, putting on a suit, and then going to help kids who you got to motivate them to go on and take the challenge of going to college. That was a... Those are some moments I feel like I'm going to be able to pull from when things get harder down the road.
Not a second or another. Not an hour or another. But at this moment with my arms outstretched, I need you to...
So... As you guys saw, my name is Randolph Holly. I'm the owner and the head instructor, head designer at Mom Collect Atelier. And you will be seeing stay committed a lot on every slide. Stay committed is our motto. So you're gonna see that a lot. I try to push that in your head. You're gonna see that a lot. So get used to that. I want you to tell yourself to stay committed to whatever you got going on. So Mom Collect Atelier is a brand that empowers people through the discovery of their artistic voice. And to simplify that for a lot of people, it just means when we always say, oh, I'm not an artist, or I'm not gifted in that manner. So I like to say I'm the person that'll help you find that voice, or help you find that gift. You might not be a Picasso or a high-end designer, but you definitely have, you know, artistic voice in there. So I like to feel like I'm the person that can bring that out. And so we do that with our brand through three different tiers: clothing design, which is some of the designs you're seeing here, from different collections we had. The shorts are from our summer collection. They were really hot. I like the vibrant colors, so they worked out well. Creative direction, event production, just simply me helping out other people. So me actually putting my services out for other people, helping them create their visions, bringing their visions to life. With event production, even helping fashion shows, helping people have fashion shows, having my own fashion shows, pop-up shops, just things to actually get out and be seen outside of, say, the internet, and just control the physical space in the world for, you know, for a couple of hours to let people actually feel you, come out, talk to you, and just get, you know, get a real feel of who you are and what you got to offer. And then the last one is the Stay Committed Shops. And it's just educational workshops. That was me on the recording, and I have an educational background. So with that, it's three workshops that I developed that I want to use to, you know, continue to create a community for, you know, for the youth, for the creators, for the minority creators, which I'm going to speak a little bit more on that. But this is just the light breakdown of what we got going on at the moment. So again, stay committed. We're going to keep putting that in. And these two kids, this is actually our kids' hoodies right now. So stay committed. I'm really, you know, pushing it right now, especially with it being wintertime. It get a little harder to wake up and get to it. So you might be asking, why is Mom Collect Atelier here? MCA is just short for Mom Collect Atelier. And just to touch on Atelier, that's just French for workshop. And so we're not just a clothing brand. We're actually a workshop where we like to teach people. We like to sell our own stuff. So that's why you see the Atelier. That's just what that means. So why are we here? MCA has noticed a major lack of representation and unity amongst minorities in the creative and design industries. So I actually didn't do any research. I actually have physical experience of being a designer who's kind of self-taught. You know, I didn't go to school for it. So it was something I just kind of got out there and did. I did make a big move during my life that I'll kind of touch on as well. But I just... Everything that I have developed my company from comes from just hitting the ground, going to these different places and just experiencing this with my own eyes and just having to grow through it and go through it. So that's where a lot of, you know, why we here, that's why we're here. So what does MCA plan to do about that? We plan, you know, MCA aims to apply our 3-tier business model to effectively expose and educate the future creative gurus and give them a community to do it with. Simply meaning, we're just trying to create that support again. You know, I feel like it takes a community to raise people. I'm a little old school. I was raised by both sets of grandparents, parents, other parents. So I feel like when you got that community behind you, when you got that circle, you can definitely achieve them goals. So just being supportive of our artistic people, our creative people that are going along the non-traditional tracks of career paths. But, you know, it's a new day and age. And I feel like if we can get behind them, they would be successful just like we want them to with anything else. So stay committed, each one teach one. And just basically meaning the brand aims to expose minority youth interested in fashion and design, how to participate and join the fashion industry, and the many ins and outs they will have to learn to rise to the top. Again, the brand has been developed from a grassroots perspective to uplift the minority youth, artists, and designers to a point of feeling adequate. And so again, that's meaning I've had moments, you know, throughout my experience where I didn't feel adequate. I didn't know the vocabulary. I didn't know the knowledge. I didn't know price points. I didn't know certain things to where people weren't educating me on that. So I had to educate myself. And so for me, I felt like there was a gap and, you know, I just wanted to fill that gap. So that's my whole thing about filling that gap, making sure that, you know, we are there. And just even going a little deeper into this, I moved to Los Angeles about 5 years ago, I would say. I've been here for a year now. So still fairly new, but, you know, enjoying the move because it definitely was a good move. But living in Los Angeles, again, that was me on the recording. I was actually homeless for about a year and a half. And I was also working as a college advisor for high school students at Crenshaw High School. And so, and I also had my dream of, you know, being a designer. So I dealt with, you know, a lot of those things and the design became an outlet, you know, for me to actually just kind of get away from that pain of not having, you know, family out there, not having, you know, a place, a steady place to stay. So, and again, like I said, having to make a decision sometimes on what money is really going to be spent on. And so for me, I just want to be able to, you know, any kid or any person that wants to make that jump, I want to be able to kind of fill those gaps for them, be able to kind of point them in different directions, give them different context. So it won't be as hard for everybody else as maybe it was for me. So it's kind of saying, kind of for me, covering up those puddles so that you don't have to walk in the water. And that's kind of my mentality. So I feel like if I could teach one person, then the next one teach one. So that's the each one teach one kind of philosophy. That's what really differentiate our brand. We're not just trying to sell you clothes. We're trying to sell your lifestyle. We're trying to sell you a community of people that actually you might not would have known if you had found the brand. So we're just trying to connect people together, like minds, good energy together. So again, stay committed. We play to win. What's the game if we don't have competitors to play against? So there's a few brands that I have, you know, got a lot of respect for them, but I also view them as opponents, you know, and probably for, you know, a few different things. So I like to touch on them and also give them, you know, they flowers and give them some exposure as well. Toast to the Gods, James Rebel, Seven Stitches, and Rework. And, you know, I basically feel like they, you know, are my opponents in a way. And it's a friendly competition for me. But I know some of the creators in these brands. I've kind of worked with them before. So it's just a friendly competition of just seeing, you know, who's more ahead of one another, who's thinking more progressive, you know, who's, you know, trying, taking more risks. And so I just feel like, you know, when it comes to those four brands, I kind of always take a peek at them, see what they're doing, and just kind of keep it moving. And so what, you know, here at Mom Collect Atelier, we got three principles that, you know, really set us apart. And one of those, we offer store quality garments at a better price, and we are set on our exclusivity of each garment produced. So we making vintage tees already ready. We're making those outside of the store price. So you're paying maybe $100, we're charging $40 for it. And then we're not making them in bulk. So the exclusivity, everybody wants to be rare, one-on-ones, maybe a one-on-none. So we make an exclusivity, no more sometimes than 24 shirts, 24 pieces. getting made. So you could definitely not expect to see somebody immediately in the same piece. So we feel like that really set us apart. That really, you know, makes us rare. And, you know, so our second one is that we aim to educate every customer of the process and procedures of the creation of our quality garments. So that's the stay committed shops. So when people buy stuff from us, we want to reach out to you guys and invite you all to come out to the workshops and actually learn about making the products that you actually buy from us. And so that's just something, again, that maybe a lot of people won't teach you how to do, you know, what you're actually buying from them. But again, like I said, we're trying to create a community. So it may be somebody buying my clothes that want to create, but just don't have, you know, the confidence to get out there and do it. So they buy a piece, they come to the shop just off of wanting to meet me, and then we kind of connect in and they learn a new skill or maybe something they was already interested in. So that's definitely something that, you know, we aim to do with our customers. That's how we like to keep our connection with our customers. And as you can see, we seek to build a family aspect amongst our customers through our stay committed shops. And that's basically just, again, just locking people in.
Oh. You at time, so you want to give a close
up. Oh, got you. Okay. Yeah. And just to close it up, I thought, I was like, man, what happened? But just to close it up, just want to say this. When I came to this program, when I went to Miss Ocelia, when I got our contact, I was really just hungry for knowledge. And I've been calling it like knowledge currency. And I think you guys have really made me wealthy with it, you know, and I would like definitely recommend anybody who has that dream, because the dream actually takes structure. And I'm a big dreamer. So you guys gave me so much structure and it just made me breathe easy. I've been breathing easy since I met y'all. So I'm like, man. So I just like to say thank you to everybody. You know, I see some familiar faces too. And I've had conversations with y'all. So I just want to say thank you to my fellow cohort group. Thank y'all. We've had some moments where we've been able to help each other grow together too. So that's all I got. Again, stay committed. I'm Randolph Holly, the owner of Mom Collect Atelier. Thank you.
Awesome. So great presentation, Randolph. And thank you for being a part of this cohort. Typically, we do have probably one or two males to drop in, and you definitely share some great knowledge and expertise and some awesome backgrounds with us every evening. So we appreciate that. So I have several questions from social world, but I'd like to open up the floor here to us here virtually. And if you guys have any questions, go ahead and jump in and ask Randolph your question. Any questions here? Okay. So I'll start with the social questions and then you can put them in the chat and then we will keep this party rolling. So Randolph, the first question, and you kind of answered it a little bit with the meaning of atelier, but there's a question of what does mom mean? Yeah, so there's another one in there too. So we have that in social world too. Can you tell us what the MOM is for?
Oh yeah, so I didn't touch on that, but mom just means Mond of Miami. It's two different meanings, but it's Mond of Miami. And I don't know if y'all saw my name, Miami was in quotations, where that's my creative alter ego. So I like to separate it, and Miami is my alter ego. So the Mond in Miami is just all the creations. Just I guess Miami is my risky side. So that's all the stuff I'm not willing to say, but willing to, you know, create and put out there. And me and my mom are like best friends. So I just had to do something to make her smile every time she seen it. So that was perfect for me. So it worked out. It's just them two things.
Okay. That's awesome. Next question is your brand only for youth?
No, it's actually for adults. I'm just getting into the youth. Yeah, okay. So the youth side is just the more educational side, kind of trying to teach some of the kids. Because I work in education too with a lot of high schoolers who do different things like graphic design and stuff like that. And I always see they don't have like a lot of those programs at the high schools anymore. So that's something I just kind of want to fill a gap with. But no, I just really make all unisex adult clothes right now. I'm just tapping into the youth.
Okay. One of the viewers said, much respect for what you're doing. Keep up the great work. And another question is, what made you choose clothing as a way to share your message?
You know what? I'm an introvert. And I like to call myself an introvert. I guess I could be extroverted when needed, but I didn't talk a lot growing up. And I express myself a lot through my dress. That's how you can kind of tell the mood I am. So if I'm wearing like dark colors, I'm probably not in a good mood. If I'm wearing brighter colors, I'm probably in a better mood. And so that's kind of been a thing for me. And I got two older sisters, so clothes have been a thing for me my whole life. My sister worked in retail, so she always bought me clothes forever. And she would buy me the colors. And so when I was feeling good, I would wear a yellow polo. But if I wasn't feeling good, I'd probably wear a darker color. So,
wait a minute. You have on all black.
Mm-mm, this navy blue and black. I offset it. This the strong vibes right here.
Gotcha. See, I just wanted vibes. To clarify.
Yeah, it's navy blue and black. See, all black would have been too sad, you know that. So yeah, I did the navy blue and black. Yeah.
Okay, I'm just trying to make sure you're in a good mood tonight.
Yeah, I mean, I was about business tonight, so I wanted to like have a sleek look.
I like it. Okay, so we do have a question. Have you considered adding a nonprofit component for your community-focused effort?
Yep. And I learned that, actually, that bright idea hit me through working with you all. I learned that through going to classes, like, I'm going to have to add a nonprofit sector for my educational side. Yeah. Through Miss Colette got me one time, the group. So, yeah.
Awesome.
That's definitely in the notes.
All right. Thanks well, let's... Oh, go ahead.
No, I was saying thanks to Level Up. That's where the idea really came from.
Awesome. Well, let's give Randolph another round of applause on an amazing business and presentation. Okay, so next up on our list of presenters for tonight. Well, first of all, we have a little extra time. So how you guys enjoyed that presentation? Let's do some emoji responses. Let's just give off some love to Randolph in his presentation on tonight. All right. Okay, so next we have Miss Beatrice Dodd. I call her Miss B, but Beatrice Dodd, she is going to render her presentation. And Miss B, you have to say your company's name again for me because it's not on my screen. So can you say the name of your business again for me? You're on mute.
The name of the company is Dr. Landscape Professionals.
Dr. Landscape Professionals. So I'll give a note about Miss B. So Miss B is representing her husband's company and how she is helping him to refocus and gain some new insights on his company. So hats off to Miss B for being a part of the program, because she mentioned to us that she retired. So now she's taking this portion of her life to focus and help her husband, which I thought was very awesome. She was there every week. She took notes. She asked great questions. And so we are going to kick it over to Ms. B so that she can present her company. The floor is yours, Ms. B.
Thank you for that wonderful introduction. Tough act to follow. Let's see. Okay, are we on? Presenting Dr. Landscape Professionals, LLC, Giving Landscape Life. Dr. Landscape Professionals, LLC, will stampede the landscape industry by specializing in hydromulch and erosion control. Dr. Landscape Professionals, LLC, will be targeting government procurement throughout the Tarrant County area. As the founder of this woman-owned small minority business, currently we are in the seed stage of the business. I have made a major corporate decision to recruit and delegate an administrative staff with experience in marketing strategies and technology. I would like to introduce this powerful team. As she mentioned, my husband, Mr. Furman Dodd, he is our honorary founder. He has taken an unexpected illness as of 2/5/2019. He has over 30 years of expertise in hydromulch and erosion applications. As the founder, Mr. Dodd taught me that just because you have a recipe doesn't mean you know how to make a cake taste good. Well, Mr. Dodd has taught me how to make the grass grow with full coverage with his secret blends. I have coupled his techniques with an Associate of Science Business Administration degree from Gordon College, Martinsville, Georgia. Julia Dodd, she is our firstborn. She has taken leadership with assisting me in restructuring her dad's business concepts. She is the company CEO. She has an associate degree in Applied Science Office Administration, Georgia, from Jonesboro, Georgia. This has positioned Dr. Landscape Professionals, LLC, as a third generation family entrepreneurship. To make a long story short, it is in our DNA. I am seeking capital for the business to advance digital technology, integrating hydromulch and erosion control to economize a virtual management system to oversee through research and marketing, minimizing our expenses while increasing revenue rapidly. We are servicing two lucrative areas of landscaping. That is hydromulch and erosion control. And for you of those that don't know what this quite entails, hydromulching is also known as hydro seeding. It is a grass planting process that is expedient, efficient, and economical. Erosion control is the practice of preventing or controlling wind or water erosion in agriculture, land development, coastal areas, and riverbank constructions. Dr. Landscape Professionals, LLC mission is to ensure professional landscape installation using sound environmental practices with competitive rates. This administration will be dedicated to ensure that the company will focus on training employees to follow our mission, policies and procedures that are in place and that are profitable. Our driven purpose is that this business is for profit. I've been inspired also by my parents' business, the opportunities that they had and they encountered as being government 8A contractors. They had over 400 employees. this is my personal commitment aside of my husband's legacy, is to make our legacy even greater. Dr. Landscape Professionals' goals is to transform lives by providing benefits for many family generations to come. Eventually, the company does plan to go public, providing additional profits in the stock market for individuals also. Between 2015 and 2021, our current year, the market size of the landscaping service industry actually have increased faster than the economy with the innovations and infrastructure that has been taking place. This has given us an edge over the economy. The Level Up business program has been instrumental in helping me take a closer look. It has increased my awareness. It has provided me tools to examine my target market through research by assuming the business with a magnifying glass. I'm more prepared to tackle revenue and cash flow challenges. I've learned effective marketing and branding is the front seat driver. I do want to take this opportunity to thank you for the priceless nuggets of knowledge, encouragement, support, and the listening ear that you all have deposited into Dr. Landscape's mission. There's a special thank you to Ocelia, Darlisa, Janae, Colette, Marcel, and also all of my fellow CEOs. We are still once again in a startup stage. This is our website and our phone number. And we want to take this opportunity, or I want to take this opportunity once again for listening tonight and being a part of this journey.
Let's give Ms. B a round of applause for your amazing presentation. Thank you so much. So thorough and so well put together. I love it. So we do have some questions, of course, in virtual world. So you have lots of hearts going up. I do want to say this, Randolph, can you put your website and whatnot in the chat? We have a question asked about that. But for Ms. B, so you talked about it a little bit and someone asked, could you talk a little bit about hydro mulching? So you did talk about kind of what it was with the seeding and whatnot. So for that person that didn't really hear that part, can you talk about hydro mulching a little bit?
Hydro mulch, first of all, the equipment, there's a large machine, there's certain gallons that it holds. That tank can be anywhere from 300 to 1700 gallons mixture. And that is in the form of seed fertilizer and mulch. And what that does, the mulch holds the seed and fertilizer in place, which makes a faster germination. It is sprayed out of a somewhat of a water hose or a fire hydrant hose, you could say. And once again, it's the techniques of how it's applied, whether it's applied correctly or incorrectly. And first of all, and then also the mixture of seed, like I mentioned, it's kind of like making a cake. You still have secret ingredients that you add a little more or add a little less depending on your area that you're covering, whether it be on a slope, whether it be flat, whether it's going to rain the next day. Those are all the things you have to take into consideration. So, but basically it's a form of seeding. It's a third the cost of sod, so it's very economical and cost effective. And if done properly, you will have grass in 7 days if watered properly.
Ooh, nice. I need to get with you guys for some, that's more of my husband's thing. He's into the grass, but you'll be hearing from us for sure. Thank you so much. So a question in the chat, which steps have you taken to access government contracts?
Well, the first, one of the first steps that I've made, I've met the mayor of Arlington and I reached out to the purchasing department in Arlington. So I'm going to start in Arlington, which is where I reside, and then expand further to Mansfield and the Fort Worth area.
Awesome. Thank you. Do you have an off season? If so, how do you prepare for your off season?
There is an off season, but not an off season because grass can grow around the year. Depending on what season it is, depends on what type of grass that you plant. Ryegrass is popular for the winter areas for those that want to have green grass all year round. But because it does not make it through the summer, it's type of overseeding. So that being said, there is no off season. There is technically, but there's not.
Thank you for that answer. Another question is, are your services for residential or commercial?
I'm actually mainly focusing on government and commercial. No residential at this time.
Awesome, thank you.
You are going for the big stuff.
She's going for the big stuff. You heard it, she's going for the big stuff. Last question is, how long have you guys been in operation? This sounds like an amazing company.
The new company just formed in January 2021. We've spent the majority of the year doing planning. Once again, we're in the seed operation, but as far as hydro mulch, my husband, I've been married since 1982. So actually my husband started doing it in 1983. And we moved to another area where it was not as known, because once again, this process, if it's not done right, it could not build a great reputation as it would in an area where it is known. And Texas is one of those areas where they're familiar with it. So we just relocated back here to continue the business. But in the dormant area, I call it dormant, we've also done other areas of landscaping. I've mowed 100 acres a week. We've planted hundreds of trees. So I've been there, got the t-shirt, and hydro mulch wins the award. It's not as labor intense, and it's a lot more lucrative. Awesome. I had to cut a lot of grass to make what I would do in my contract. So that's kind of the rationale then.
Well, thank you so much again. Let's give Ms. B another round of applause. Ms. B, please be sure to put your information in the chat so I can transfer it over to Social World for them to have access to that as well. Okay, so next we have Ms. Roslyn with Roslyn's Cleaning Service, who is going to render us her presentation. So I have to say this about Ms. Roslyn. So the very first night of Level Up, Roslyn came in blazing. She's answering questions. She's like on fire. So her energy made me excited for this next startup or this next cohort that we had. So I was always excited to see Ms. Roslyn. And Ms. Roslyn always had the best dinner, okay? Like, she had the best dinner on the call. And it doesn't look like she's, you know, a very big person, but her dinner always looked really, really good. So in addition to her energy that she brought to the class, she always brought us a really good appetite for afterwards, because she had really good dinner. Well, it looked like it was really good. So I am excited to bring to you Miss Broslyn of Broslyn's Cleaning Service. Miss Broslyn, the floor is yours.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for having me. My name is Broslyn Mosley. I'm the owner of Broslyn's Cleaning Service Small Business. Just started up this year in January, so I'm 10 months strong. Purpose of my business is, since COVID, you know, there was a big, you know, strike. You know, everybody needed to make sure that, you know, their homes, their businesses were up to par. You know, safety is the main key now. If it has never been before, you know, it became a big priority, you know, last year. So that put me in a good position to, you know, take part in making sure that I was doing my part to help maintain those safety protocols and, you know, keeping the environment clean and, you know, ready for, you know, businesses, homes, you know, just helping out, lending a hand. So that is what my business is for, you know, not just per COVID, but just for, you know, personal needs as well. I want to be able to lend an extra hand to help someone that not able, that may work as, you know, work much, you know, so I can be there to pick up that slack for you if needed. So there's always a need for it, no matter which way you look at it. So I wanted to, you know, start my business. I did a project last year. Going in, I wasn't sure, you know, what the project was. I thought it was just, you know, a regular job. But once I got there and started getting the information and what it was for, I learned that we were reconstructing in a hotel building to house the homeless. So that really, you know, struck with me, because there last year a lot of people lost their homes, you know, along with individuals that were already less fortunate. So I wanted to, you know, really put my all into helping, you know, build that and, you know, helping that project come along. And just in the midst of doing my job, you know, my performance is what helped me to gain access to become my own business owner and still do that same thing, because not only was I doing it, you know, for a job, I was doing it giving back. So my purpose for my business is still the same. I just want to be able to give back. I just want to be able to help, you know, and also keeping, you know, your homes, your businesses, maybe even your cars, you know, in good standings, because we need to make sure that we are maintaining a clean environment no matter where we are. So it is a passion. You know, not everybody likes to clean, or, you know, it is not a particular way of doing it. But if any way that I could give back and, you know, just help someone in the smallest way, as, you know, just coming and wiping down something, I want to be able to do that. I've, you know, researched, you know, a lot of competitors, and, you know, we're all doing the same thing. But I like to say I'm not, you know, doing it as much for the money per se, but, you know, as I keep mentioning, it's just giving back, you know, if whatever comes is going to come. So that what makes me different from a lot of other companies out here. You know, we're not all doing it for the same reason per se, but, you know, much respect to them. I look up to everybody because I'm startup. So I'm willing to learn and take something from anybody that's willing to, you know, give back to me so that I can be in a position to pay it forward to the next person. So it's, you know, it's still a learning process for me, you know, growing. So but it's never going to stop be a learning process for me. So just looking, you know, at what the next person is doing and gaining that knowledge from the way that they're moving or how they're handling their business is what's going to help me in the long run. So I want to always keep my mind open, you know, to things like that. And, you know, my target clients are, you know, I have a son that has asthma, so I want to be able to, you know, connect with those individuals. And, you know, I have chemical free, you know, supplies that don't have any chemicals in it, you know, that don't have a smell, you know, for a lot of people you know, sometimes the fumes could, you know, make them flare up if they have certain conditions. So I want to be able to reach those individuals as well as the elderly that aren't able to, you know, get up and move around as much. So, you know, just being in, you know, this program, it, you know, just brought me, you know, helped me narrow down, because when I started, I was like, I want to, you know, work with everybody. I want all the clients, you know, no matter who they are. But, you know I had to kind of have my particular set. So because I'm personally dealing with my child that has asthma, and just the products that I use around him and see how it, you know, affects him and makes, you know, makes him better, I want to be able to give that back to other individuals as well. And like I say, the elderly. So like that's another reason why I want to do my business. And like I said, a lot I'm learning here in CTL. They actually broke down a lot of things as far as the target, you know, market and your clients and just the way that we're going about our business. Just the main thing, is it really something that you wanted to do? And like it is. I say it's the giving back process. You know, you give to get, and I get joy out of, you know, just like something so simple as just cleaning, you know, so it makes a big difference. I'm still in my learning stage. Like I said, I'm only 10 months in, so I still have forever to go, no matter where this business take me, how far it takes me. So I do want to just thank, you know, CTL for helping me. You know, even Katrina has played a big part in, you know, helping my business get to where it is. Like, she played a major role. We've sat on the phone for hours at a time, and, you know, she just, you know, helped my business jumpstart to just the place where it is right now. So I can just give thanks to everybody, you know, even Miss Ocelia. Like, she just brought out that, you know, when I talked to her, it was like, everything just comes out so smoothly, you know, just being able to express, you know, my passion behind why I do what I do and why I want to do it. So, like, this program is really helpful and just, you know, helping us understand, is it something that you really want to do? Why do you want to do it? You know, and just breaking down the points of your business and, you know, how to be successful as a business owner. So I'm sorry I didn't have a fancy presentation. I almost wanted to run off when everybody else was putting theirs up there. But I mean, like, we all, you know, we're all here in competition in some way or another, but we're all learning and growing, and just the energy and the vibes and just seeing how 6 weeks ago to now we've all grown to be where we are today is a blessing. And I'm just, you know, proud of each and every one of us, you know, for making it as far as we have, because I know that there were challenges. But I do residential and commercial cleaning and some clean up, clean out, construction cleaning as well. So I'm interested in Airbnbs as also, so I really don't want to limit myself to what I'm capable of doing. So just giving the opportunity to prove what I'm capable of doing will really just help, you know, put me out there a little bit more, because right now I'm running on word of mouth, and that has helped me so far and where my business is right now. So I'm sorry I couldn't present you with pictures. Maybe some of them were a bit graphic because I do tend to get a little dirty in my work, but I love it in the end just to see the aftermath of it, because you would not think that the before and after were the same place. So I get joy in that too. But, you know, thank you for the opportunity, CTL, and, you know, Miss Marcel, like everybody here. Like, I, you know, can go on and on about, you know, the growth here and the things that I've learned by myself and by my business. So, but I just want to thank you guys again for just the opportunity to be able to present myself and my business. And, you know, I'm just thankful for what's going to come out of it.
Oh, let's give Roslyn a round of applause. Thank you so much for presenting tonight and sharing with us your passion for your business. And it's okay you to have a presentation. You know, you're here, you presented, you told us about it, and that's a lot more than other people have done. So congratulations and kudos to you for sharing your business. If you could put your website or email in the chat so I can make sure I get that over to social media world. And one question that I do have that came from social world is, how far do you see yourself going with your cleaning business aspiration?
Honestly, as far as it take me, you know, I want to set limits or boundaries on myself, because then that's saying that I'm not worthy of, you know, opportunities that come. So even if I get the opportunity to go to another state and I'm ready, I'm going to go, because that's an opportunity presented to me. Somebody seeing my work and my worth and willing to give me the opportunity to travel and, you know, do my job there. So I will, wherever it takes me is where I'm going. So I'm just going to keep my mind open and stay prayed up and just hoping for the best, and wherever, you know, whatever comes out of.
Awesome. Thank you. Another question. Do you have a pricing structure set?
I mean, that's depending on what the job entails. So I wouldn't just say this is the amount for this, because you can tell me anything over the phone or, you know, per email. I get there, the job doesn't match up. So if I give you a price and then when I get there, you know, I don't want to be disappointed. I don't want you to be disappointed. So I would rather you submit, you know, your work, your quote, and I will come and do my walkthrough and we can see what the job entails. And from there, I will be able to give you the most accurate pricing. So, and I'm willing to price compare with, you know, any other services that you may have already, you know, looked at. So the options are always open. So I wouldn't want to put a price out there and you hold me to that, because it does change just depending on what the work entails.
Awesome. So this comment, it has laughing emojis with it, and it says, would you share with us one of your worst experiences doing a cleaning, because I'm sure you've seen it all.
I'm laughing at you, because if you only knew. a job I just did recently. We cleaned out a room, and just not try to get a little graphic, but we got beat up by a bunch of different people, critters that were in there. So it got real crazy. If I'd have put myself together a little bit better to present those pictures, like, you would have seen, like, I'm cute, but I don't mind getting dirty. Let me just say that. So whatever you have, bring it on to me.
Awesome. Thank you so much. Let's give Roslyn another round of applause. Thank you so much, Roslyn, for your business presentation. And if you haven't done so already, put your information in chat so I can get that over to social world. Okay, so next we have Miss Jakeisha, who has joined us, and Jakeisha shared her birthday with us, so we got to celebrate her on her birthday. She tuned in to Level Up when it was her birthday. So Miss Jakeisha, the floor is now yours, ma'am.
Hello, my name is Jakeisha McGivry, and I am the owner of Women of Hope and Love Transitional Home. And I do have a presentation, so give me one second. Let me see if I can share my screen. Oops, sorry. Okay, here we are. So Again, my name is Jakeisha, and I am the owner of Women of Hope and Love Transitional Home. So my inspiration is volunteering and working with women at shelters and group homes. Our concept is to provide shelter for working women. Our concept is to provide shelter for working low income to income earning women throughout the communities who are without shelter and is looking to build stability throughout their short-term stay. And my value proposition is for single, accompanied, and unaccompanied women whom is looking for affordable housing to gain stability. Our transitional home provides a safe and carefree environment with women of love and hope. Transitional home, you will feel accomplished, safe, and drama-free. And my services and products, my short-term emergency shelter, temporary residential shelter for displaced domestic violence victims, transition families caught in crisis, and offering varieties of services within the scope of the community. And the benefits is a stable place to stay, clean and drama-free environment. We provide hot meal preparation and additional resources. And the cost is room and boarding will be $500 with accompanied women and $700 with unaccompanied women with children. Okay, so there are permits and licensing required. The budget for permits and licenses is $2,000. The cost for computer software, apps, payroll, and CRM software, real estate software is $7,000. The cost for launching an official website is $600. Stationery and utility deposits is $2,000. The equipment for the office is $7,000. Investment amount is $25,000. And I have rent, of course, $1,800, lights $500, internet $160, and water $120. And I do have my contact information here. Jakeisha, my phone number, and email womenofhopeandlove@gmail.com.
Right. Thank you, Jakeisha, for your amazing presentation. Sounds very interesting. Thank you for sharing that with us tonight. So as you guys gather your questions for Ms. Jakeisha, I do have one question. What made you choose to do a transitional home for your company?
Due to, I've been in that position before as far as being a single parent and looking for a transition or looking for someone to stay that's affordable until I get on my feet. Until I was able to get on my feet. So, and it was kind of hard trying to go into a women's shelter or, you know, any type of shelter to get assistance. So I decided to. I've always wanted to help women anyway, just from what I've been through, again, just life, period. So, and I've always just wanted to help because that's been instilled and being installed in me. So,
awesome. Thank you so much. Are you currently providing services, and how did you choose to go the route of for-profit instead of nonprofit?
No, I am not currently providing services. I'm actually still in the process of finding a home. And actually, I went from nonprofit to profit because I know going into nonprofit, it would definitely assist me into getting where I need to be as far as starting nonprofit. I come to realize it'll be a little bit harder starting up with the nonprofit than, you know, a profit. But eventually, hopefully, I will be doing nonprofit.
Awesome. Thank you so much for sharing. Another question, have you thought about partnering with some local organizations, or is that on your radar?
Yes, I actually have thought about partnering with different organizations. I've actually been in contact with different organizations on partnering with them, of course. And I have some good recommendations. I'm also partnering right now with someone who's already opened up a group home and had a group home. So she's been a big inspiration for me as of right now.
Awesome. What area are you looking to have your home in?
So far, I'm looking on, I haven't really just pinpointed the exact area, but I know for sure it will be on the east side of Fort Worth.
Awesome. Thank you so much. When do you envision yourself having this business up and going?
I envision myself having this business up and going within about, I would say, just fully blown going within about 2 years, if not sooner.
Okay. One last question that I have on my end is, if someone wanted to assist you in your efforts, where is your biggest area of need currently?
Finding a home, purchasing a home. Well, yeah.
Okay, finding the home for the business operation, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Awesome. Okay, well, let's give Jakeisha another round of applause. Jakeisha, please make sure to put your information in the chat box as well so that we can get that over to social media world. Well, guys.
Thank you.
This has been an amazing journey. I am so grateful at the opportunity to have been able to serve as your facilitator for the program. I do hope that you guys were able to find value in what it is that you learned and the people that you met and the outcomes that you were able to achieve. For us at the North Texas Entrepreneur Education and Training Center, we ask that you would stay connected. There are so many awesome resources and ways to continue in that mission of growing your business. And don't ever give up, right? There's a quote that says, I don't know the exact words, but the moment you give up is the moment you have failed. So again, the simple fact that you guys are here tonight and you shared your story, you had engagement, you have people watching on social media world. And like I said, the hearts and the likes and all that were just like going crazy, because we're proud of you guys. You took that step, you made that effort, and guess what? Entrepreneurship is not easy. However, if you stay focused on moving forward, you will absolutely achieve the goals that were meant for you. So kudos to you guys. Hats off to you guys for the amazing work that you've done, not only in this program, but to get your business to where it is today. And I'm looking forward to looking back in the future and saying, ooh, I knew them when. So don't forget about your girl, okay? You know, just come back and give me a high five, or I like hugs too. I know it's COVID, but I do like hugs. So please be sure to stay connected. I would also like to personally invite all of you guys to come and be a part of the Center North Texas with me at any given time, because you are a participant of our cohort. You have special privileges to come and hang out. So please stay connected. Stay tuned to your emails for some additional information, and we will make sure that you guys get what you need. Before I close out, I'd like to turn it back over to Ocelia with Center for Transforming Lives for any closing remarks. And she can open it up to anyone else if they have closing remarks as well.
Okay, awesome. Thank you, Darlisa. Well, congratulations to everyone, all of our entrepreneurs. You all did a wonderful job on your presentation. So congrats. See, I hope it wasn't as bad as some of you were anticipating it was. Hope it wasn't that bad. Always be ready to spread the word about your venture. Always be ready to get support, to connect with others, and potentially get some business. So this was a great, great opportunity for you all, to prepare to pitch your businesses to the public. So I am excited, and we do want to announce, we do have another cohort that will be kicking off soon. October the 29th will be our last cohort. Yes. For this year, for anyone that is watching, I have to put the plug in again. If you are interested in joining the Level Up program, please contact us. I believe Darlisa already posted the link, but I will say it one more time. LevelUpTarrantCounty.eventbrite.com. That is LevelUpTarrantCounty.eventbrite.com. And a third time, LevelUpTarrantCounty.eventbrite.com. Log on there and register for our upcoming info sessions. We have two more coming up this month before our last cohort begins to get more information about this program and how you can get involved. And I don't know if Charlotte or Charlotte has anything to say. Blink twice, shake your head.
Thank you. Charlotte just stopped. I said, thank you again for hosting Darlisa and for partnering with us. And congrats again, entrepreneurs. And we're looking forward to hearing more about where your business goes.
Awesome. Charlotte, did you want to?
My household is a little loud right now, but. Just great job to everyone. And, you know, as Charlotte and I think Ocelia said as well, we're excited to follow you on your journey. And we're always here if you need to come back with any questions. And don't forget about the grant opportunities that you have as well that I'm sure Ocelia has shared with you.
Awesome. Well, thank you guys so much again. I just loaded a bunch of information in the chat box about the ribbon cutting and the grand opening, which all of you guys are welcome to attend. Without further ado, I would like to send you off to your world of blessings for your business. And thank you guys so much again for being a part of the Level Up program. We will catch you guys next time. Bye, everyone.